How worthless is education? Let me count the ways in my worthless college degree. Worthless. That's what a college degree is worth. Here's my worthless law degree. Equally as worthless. Here's my worthless license to practice law. Worthless. And here's my worthless computer science degree. Also worthless. That's the value of education.
If somebody were graduating from high school today and wanted to know whether they should go to college, I would say they should run, not walk, away from college. Because the industrial age doesn't have long to go. There's no way that I would encourage somebody to go 4 years or more to undergraduate school, rack up a bunch of debt, and learn a bunch of nonsense that isn't going to do them any good when there's no fuel at the filling station, no food at the grocery store, and no water coming out of the municipal taps. Well, why would you go to college to go into a huge amount of debt to get nothing in return, not even something that might facilitate your survival, much less your ability to thrive? So at this point, at this late era in the industrial economy, I wouldn't encourage anybody to go to college. It hasn't been a very good deal for quite a while, and it certainly is a really bad deal now.
I confer upon you the degree for which you have worked so hard, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto. Congratulations.
As fast as college tuition costs are rising, the value of a college degree is declining even faster. The youth in America today need to be taught to think for themselves and realize that there is no value to having a college degree if everyone else has one.
I was in the student union where graduation was about to take place, and they had a series of plaques on the wall. And they listed all the students who had graduated with a 4.0 grade point average. And the first plaque had, you know, all the plaques were basically full of names. But the first plaque had the first 50 or 60 years of the university represented. To fill that plaque with the 20 or so names on it required 50 or 60 years of higher education. Of course, in the most recent 5 years, there are multiple plaques for every year. We're churning out 4.0 students at the rate of a couple hundred a year. That used to mean something. You know, if you're the only person that in the first 40 years of the history of the institution to have a 4.0, that's meaningful. Now everybody's a 4-point student. Our standards have fallen so profoundly that anybody with a heartbeat can get a 4-point average. It's just absurd.
The U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics reported in April of last year that, as of October 2009, 70.1% of 2009 high school graduates were enrolled in colleges or universities, an all-time high since they began keeping this statistic, and up from 68.6% of 2008 high school graduates enrolling into college. In other words, there is no longer anything special about a college degree in America if 70% of everybody else is also attending college to receive one. NIA is working hard to ensure that it will soon become common knowledge in the U.S. that a college degree gives you no advantage over the rest of the population. When Americans finally learn the truth, the college bubble in America will burst.
College enrollment has been increasing really since the late 80s, but what kind of is an unknown secret is since 1992, the majority of college graduates, 60% of them were in positions that the BLS considered low skill and typically did not require a high school education. For example, 20% of all the new waiter and waitressing positions created since 1992 have been filled by college graduates.
Of the 29.9% of recent high school graduates not in college, 70% of them were able to successfully find jobs without a college degree. These Americans are already building important workforce experience, which NIA considers to be far more valuable than any piece of paper. By comparison, only 42.1% of recent high school graduates in college have a job. And most of these are part-time jobs where the students are building very little workforce experience. The 57.9% of students in college without jobs, not only are they wasting their savings and getting deeply into debt for a worthless piece of paper, but they are losing out on valuable income they could have been earning during those 4 years. One of the greatest myths in America today that is used to scam Americans into overpaying to attend college is that college graduates make more money in their lives than Americans without college degrees, and therefore a college degree is a great investment. According to studies from biased organizations like the College Board, Americans with college degrees will earn $1 million in additional income over their lifetime compared to high school graduates with no college degrees.
You know that college graduates earn $1 million more on average than those without a degree?
Graduates from four-year colleges earn nearly an estimated $1 million more.
Most colleges and universities in America use this $1 million in additional income statistic to hype and sell their product. It has been repeated so many times that it's just about been accepted by all with nobody questioning its validity. However, for any student thinking of attending college, they need to consider the facts surrounding this number and compare it to the true cost of attending college. With the cost of annual college tuition now at $27,293, if we assume continued 5.15% college tuition inflation over the next 4 years, the average cost for a student entering college now to receive their bachelor's degree in 4 years will be $117,900. Therefore, even with the current college inflation crisis, an expenditure of $117,900 on the surface seems like a good investment if the return will be $1 million. The secret truth is, most college students do not receive their degree in 4 years. The Americans who are earning $1 million more in their lifetimes are actually spending an average of 6 years in college before receiving their degrees. Therefore, assuming continued 5.15% college tuition inflation for years 5 and 6, the total cost for the average student's degree in order to earn their $1 million in extra income will be $186,349. For those who borrow that full amount and pay it back over 10 years at a 6% interest rate, the additional interest expense would be $61,914, bringing the total cost of the degree up to $248,263. Then you need to consider the matter of lost income. The average high school graduate who finds an entry-level job without a college degree earns $35,400 per year over the first 6 years. For the majority of college students who don't have jobs, they are losing $212,400 in income over their 6 years in college. Combining the expected cost to attend college for 6 years with potential interest expenses and lost income, and now we are at a total cost of $460,663, all for the hope of earning an extra $1 million over a lifetime. Another important fact is, all of the reports that show $1 million in extra income for college graduates over high school graduates include students who receive GEDs as being high school graduates. Most GED recipients weren't motivated enough to graduate high school and therefore shouldn't be included in these statistics as real high school graduates. NIA believes GED recipients are unfairly skewing down high school graduates' average incomes. Also, the simple truth is, some Americans are just more motivated than others to make money and have successful careers. Somebody who wants to earn a high income usually goes to college because they have been suckered into believing it offers them the greatest ability to do so. Whereas most Americans who don't attend college don't have as strong a desire to have a successful career. 95% of college graduates interviewed by NIA with annual incomes above $200,000 tell us that their college degrees had absolutely nothing to do with their business success. In fact, of these same people surveyed, 90% of them said that they probably would have become successful at a much earlier age and be making even more money today if they didn't waste so many years of their life attending college. The phony $1 million in additional income study that was conceived by the education industry in order to deceive Americans into overpaying to attend college is just one of many false, misleading studies that they have created in an effort to create an illusion that college is a good investment, no matter how high tuition prices rise. The mainstream media has been working with the education industry and helping them perpetrate their schemes on the American public. One of these schemes was the 2008 pharmacist shortage hoax. 3 years ago, there were 15 new pharmacist schools getting ready to open in the U.S. In order to create artificial demand for enrollments to all of these new schools, the industry decided to create an illusion that there was a huge shortage of pharmacists in the country that will continue for the rest of the decade, with 150,000 new pharmacist jobs needed by 2020.
One place where the U.S. economy has too many jobs and not enough applicants is in pharmacies. Because there's a shortage of pharmacists, many are overworked from putting in long hours.
With pharmacies open 24 hours a day and a huge population of aging baby boomers consuming larger amounts of prescription drugs, it adds up to an industry that cannot find enough pharmacists to go around.
From the student standpoint, and our students know that when they graduate, they have a job. I mean, in fact, they have a job even before they have graduated. It's not that they can practice as a pharmacist, but they know they have been offered already a job. So that's one of the positive side. On the negative side is the pressure it's put on the schools to really come up with the number of pharmacists that are needed in the future.
By some estimates, the U.S. would need more than 150,000 new pharmacists by 2020 to match supply with industry demand. Experts say the pharmacist shortage will continue for at least a decade or more. In the meantime, at least 15 new pharmacy schools are expected to open their doors by 2010, even as existing schools expand in size.
NIA has been hearing dozens of reports from its members with family members who have graduated pharmacy schools 6 months to a year ago and have sent in their resumes to hundreds of different pharmacies in the New York metropolitan area and have yet to even receive one job offer. Even experienced pharmacists are having major difficulties finding pharmacist jobs. The husband of one NIA member retired 5 years ago as a pharmacist in New Jersey, but has now decided to re-enter the workforce so that their family can accumulate enough gold and silver to survive hyperinflation. Unfortunately, he was forced to leave his family and move to a rural part of Alabama in order to receive a pharmacist job paying only $18 per hour. Law schools have also been deceiving the public with false and misleading statistics. During the past decade, an unprecedented number of Americans went to school to become lawyers because they thought if they became a lawyer, they would immediately become rich. Some law schools are advertising that 90% of graduates are employed within 1 year of graduating. The unfortunate reality is, law schools are deceiving their students with these statistics because most of their graduates who are employed within a year of graduating are not employed at law firms. They can be employed at Walmart or McDonald's, but the law schools will still consider them to be part of their 90% employed within a year.
A lot of schools right now will tout a job placement rate after graduation, or you know, what percentage of their graduates are employed X amount of months after graduating the degree. And what you're seeing sometimes is manipulation and outright just fraud in how they calculate this. One major law school was recently admitted to hiring a bunch of unemployed illegal graduates to work in their admissions group at the same time their placement rate survey was being conducted. So yes, were they employed at the time? Yes, but it wasn't an illegal profession.
Law schools are handing out 43,000 law degrees each year, yet 15,000 attorney and legal staff jobs have disappeared since 2000.